Ironic, isn't it, that Sarnia Sting's star Neil Yakupov is now getting the rest his doctors prescribed a week ago. Yakupov, as I'm sure you know, was suspended 2 games for skipping the annual Top Prospects game, one of the CHL's premier events. David Branch cited CHL policy as the reason for the suspension, but I'm not entirely buying that. Sure, the policy exists, and yes, I understand players can't dodge their obligations without facing repercussions, which in this case was missing 2 league games. But it seems to me there's something a little more than simple policy behind the suspension. I've got to think the CHL was left a little red-faced that Yakupov took a pass on the prospects game. And there's nothing the CHL and Branch like less than being embarrassed. I can certainly see both sides of the argument here. Yakupov probably would have been better served by resting a knee injury that forced him to miss a month. But he probably didn't help his case by playing 3 games in 3 days just before the prospects game. Think the Brampton Battalion missed coach Stan Butler? In the 6 games Butler has missed while serving his 8-game suspension, the battalion has gone 1-5-0 and fallen out of top spot in the Central Division. Butler will miss games against Owen Sound and Kitchener this week before returning Sunday against Peterborough. And just in the nick of time, I have to believe. Belleville Bulls goalie Malcolm Subban, the league leader in goals against and save percentage, returned to action Friday after missing a month with a groin injury. Have to like the Bulls' chances of making the playoffs now. And it will likely come at the expense of the St. Mike's Majors or Oshawa Generals. For TorontoSun.com, I'm Dave Pollard.